this is Stanley Jack. I'm here at my parish at Stanislaus, St. Stanislaus Church. Just wanted to say that the mission of Stanley Jack is to tell the truth. Thank you.
Mis canciones son todo lo que tengo. Todo lo que tengo.
Hey, Mugs.
Hey.
How you doing?
Okay, you're doing fine. And you?
Pretty good. Yeah. Remember Stephen? Yeah, he used to call me, hey, Stan, Stanley.
Yeah.
Email, Stan.
Yeah. I still remember the first time I ever met him.
Uh-huh.
I was sitting at the table at Ridgeway, and it was me, Gary, and Cammy was sitting at the table. Steve and John came by, and it was crowded in there, and they asked me, and he just went like this and said, you don't mind if we sit here? And here John said, hi, my name is John. Hi, how you doing?
Yeah, John was like that. I met him at the Walmart. You know, Walmart? He was like there at the front, the entrance of Walmart, McKinley.
Uh-huh.
He's like that. Hi, my name is John. I'm John. And then, you know what, you know, he said, hey, you know, I talked to him about Hollywood and stuff. And then he told me his brother was in Hollywood. Like that.
Yeah.
And then I go, so, oh, his name's Stephen. And then I go, what? So I was like patrolling the McHenry Walmart parking lot, the property, and I was trying to figure out, well, whatever. And so this kid, this John, said, yeah, meet my brother. So I finally met him, and we talked about Amagis, you know, Los Angeles and stuff. And Stephen was like, come on. So I started hanging around with Stephen and John. That's when I started going to Ridgeway. That's where I met you.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And so with Steve, he had come and introduce himself and everything else, and he'd tell us what he's doing and everything else, and tell me about his thing in L.A. and everything else.
Yeah, he worked for the Metro. He was a bus driver, but he was an actor.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was an actor. Rest in peace. It's almost a year now that he's
died. I always believe, as a, you know, being part of Indian and everything else, that the spirit will always stay.
Yes, I actually, when the day he passed away, and then the following Sunday we went on Ridgeway, and somebody, you know, touched my eye, but I knew he was him. He was his spirit.
Anything like me, I was. He died in October.
October 1st.
Yeah. And I was coaching a football game, and I got the phone call in the third quarter that I didn't answer. That when the game was over, I called that number because I wanted to know who the guy was. And it was gone. And he told me that Steve passed away. And I said, no wonder my body changed and filled the, you know, the spirit inside of it, and I did not know where it came from. And then I kind of, you know,
sensed it,
that somebody passed away, and then John told me that. And all that week, I keep going, you know, somebody is around me.
Sure, you know, he's always like, hey, buddy, hello, buddy. He's always called, man. He's a real cool guy, Steve Jobs. Rest in peace, man, because...
Yeah, and once in a while, I could feel him behind me, or, like, tapping me on the shoulder. You know?
Yeah, I was just talking about, you know, here in Modesto, the Yakuts Nation, my ancestors, along the rivers, you know, like Santa Fe, you know, 132, Beckwith, they're all like villages on the river, and there were like cemeteries, you know, sacred cemeteries. And for me, coming back and forth to Modesto, I always sense, you know, spirits touching.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I've been practicing the ghost dancing. I don't know if you ever watched Billy Jack. the movie Village Up, where he did the ghost dancing. All uh-huh. I met a Lakota in L.A., and his name was Aaron Tenbears. He's a Lakota, Oglala Lakota, and he was teaching me how to ghost dance his way.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and I have my old ways, you know, from my own. My great-grandfather was a shaman. Right. So we had, you know, we bonded in Hollywood.
Yeah, we've done ghost dancing in Utah.
Utah? Yeah, that's actually the, is it the Paiute Nation or the original ghost dancers?
Yeah.
And they taught the Lakotas.
So they taught us how to do the ghost dance.
Yeah.
You know, and so they taught me that, and
that's why Stephen Jones is ghost, you know, he's a good spirit. Stephen Jones is a good ghost, you know, like a Casper the Friendly Ghost.
Yeah.
You know, so if you ever, like I said, if your ears buzz, that means somebody is visiting you. You know, if you're like that.
In our tribe, if your ear buzz on the right side, it's a good, you know, spirit that is around you. Mm-hmm. That when you hear on the left side,
is that right?
Is a bad spirit.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know,
the fallen angels, the bad angels.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And so I believe that, you know, in our tribe, that only the true, you know, good is always go upstairs.
Yeah.
And the bad is
downstairs or around us. Well, you know, like me, I'm a modern day Catholic. I believe in modern day Christian, where, you know, the good spirit, heaven and earth, to bring heaven and earth, mm-hmm. we want to be in the good, and so we want to bring heaven on earth. But there's always bad spirits around.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's why you know Chad.
Chad.
McDonald? Yeah, he's a ghostbuster. He's a real ghostbuster.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
so he's a good.
I do pick up spirits and things like that, and I believe what the Indians always say, that you can feel the good vibration and the good spirit.
Yes.
And you can feel evil spirit too.
Yeah. All right, Muggsy. Let's toast on this.
Okay.
Let's toast our friendship and remembering Stephen Jones. Stephen Jones, rest in peace.
Yep.